Hey guys, how's it going? Mark Meshter speaking from Smart Brain Academy. And in my today's video, I want to talk about, let's see, top 5 tips for new internet marketers. Okay. I actually don't have to say that much about this topic because I'm gonna explain my 5 tips, my top 5 tips for you if you're new in this business. Okay, let's start. Tip number 1, build a list. Okay, if you don't know what I mean with build a list is actually have a squeeze page in place or opt-in form on your blog, for example, and then get subscribers on your newsletter list. Okay, why it's important to build a list? I still regret that I didn't build a list from or right from the beginning, because when you build a list, you have subscribers on your list. That means if you send out an email, you get traffic to the offer you promote, to your blog post, to your video, or whatever. You can help people. You can solve their problems. You can interact with them, because just say something like, if you want to say something about it, just hit replay or reply button and reply on this email. Okay? It's quite easy. And we said with a list, with an email list, with a list of subscribers, you're not really relying on Google, because if Google, I don't know, if they decide to put out a new update or to slap down your site or whatever, you still have your list. If you send out the email, you will have traffic. Okay? And that's the reason why you have to build a list. It's like gold. Okay? Build a list, get subscribers on your list, and then help subscribers. Stay engaged with your subscribers. Tell stories. Build relationship. Okay? That's it, what you have to do if you're new in internet marketing. Tip number 2, set goals. Okay? It sounds obviously, but you have to write down your goals. And the best thing to do is write down your goals with a deadline. Okay? Because it's not enough when you say, I want to make 1,000 bucks, okay? No. It must be something like, I want to be make 1,000 bucks in the next 2 months, or until, I don't know, end of the year, something like that, okay? And you have to set goals for, I don't know, daily goals. Then you have to set goals for the months, for 3 months, 6 months, where you want to be in 1 year, okay? Set goals for it, and then check your goals every day. Have your list, I don't know, somewhere beside your desk or on the wall behind your screen. Check your goals every day and stick to it, okay? Tip number 3, choose a method and stick with it. That's really, 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 really important, especially if you're new to internet marketing, because it's really tempting. You see it all over the net, I don't know, on the different forums, on ClickBank, or when you Google something, how to make money online, you see always everywhere products, yeah, like popping up everywhere you look, and it's really tempting to buy the next shiny object, because everybody is promising something on the sales letter. Some people promise, yeah, you're gonna make 10,000 bucks the first month you try this method. And another one is saying, oh, okay, in 30 days you can have like 30,000 subscribers on your list with my method. And I had it before. Like almost every internet marketer, you're gonna buy one method or one ebook, one software, something like that. Then you try it, and you try it for 1 week, 2 weeks. And if you don't see any results, you jump to the next one, okay? Because like I said, the offers are everywhere, and if it's not working in 2 weeks, I will be sure you are jumping to the next shiny object, to the next shiny offer. But that's not good to do it because pick one method and stick to it. Okay, you have to stick to it. You have to do it I do at the moment blogging, video marketing, and Facebook marketing. Okay, and I said to myself, okay, I stick to it. I do it 3 months, 6 months, and if it's not working, but it is working, if it's not working, I could pick another offer, okay? But you don't have to pick one offer, stick to it, be a master on your offer, on this method, okay? And if you're really, really a master on it, and you can create a consistent, predictable income stream with this method, then you can outsource it because you probably bought a system or you built a system, and then you can outsource it to a freelancer, and then you can pick a new method, okay? Quite easy, like that. Okay, tip number four. If you want to go full time in your online marketing business, then you have to minimize distractions. Always minimize distraction. I mean, it's tempting. When I started out full time with my business, I sat on my PC, and I don't know. I was surfing the web, and then you have Facebook. Something on Facebook it's getting your attention, and you see that, and then you click to another thing, and another thing, and another thing, and then you're on YouTube because you want to make a little bit research on different videos, stuff like that, and you see a nice video, and you're gonna start watching this video, and then okay, you get you see a related video, and you think okay, just this one more, and then I gonna start with my work. And then you watch one video more, and more, and more, and more, and it doesn't stop. Okay, it doesn't stop. And at the end of the day, you've seen, well, you haven't really done anything. Maybe I don't know, one video and a little bit of this or this, but it's not bringing your business forward. Okay, that means minimize your distractions, turn off your TV, turn off Facebook, don't have a look at YouTube. Set a goal. For example, in this hour, I want to write a blog post, and then write the blog post, and don't stop until you finish the blog post. Okay, I do it. I give me something like a little reward. I said to myself, or I say to myself, okay, I'm gonna write this blog post. And English is not my native language. You probably heard that already. And it's quite hard sometimes for me to write blog posts. But I say to myself, okay, I'm gonna write this blog post now, and then I can watch, I don't know, one or two motivational videos, or I can have a look on Facebook for 5 minutes, okay, before I continue with working. And it's working like that. Okay, but I never watch TV. I never get distracted with stuff like that. Okay, because work time is work time, and you have to treat your business like a business. Okay, and that means work time is work time. We have to work in this time. Okay, tip number five: provide value to your customers. I mean, you can create content the whole day, but if it's just crap or stuff stuff with what you don't help people to solve a problem, then it's actually useless. Okay, you have to provide value with every video you do, like this one. You have to provide some value to your customers. I'm gonna provide value to internet newbies or new internet marketers with this video to give them some tips what to avoid and what to do. Okay, and if you write a blog post, pick a topic where people have a problem with, and if you're gonna solve this problem, people will trust you. They will build a relationship to you, And if you're gonna pitch them somewhere in the future with the offer you promote or with, I don't know, something, then they will trust you and they will buy from you because they know you always provide value and you don't sell any crap. And that's quite important. Okay, guys, that are my five tips for new internet marketers. I hope they're gonna help you a bit to get started and to avoid some mistakes. Like always, like my video and subscribe to my channel and visit my blog under marcomerstadt.com. Okay, guys, that's it for today. Have a good one. Bye.